This is Big Poppy 9 in the house. Hey, I want to share with you my second man cave. This man cave is my reloading room. And everything I don't do it on the low end. I always go extreme. So what I've done in this layout is I've got a trim case station here. I've got a 380 press. I got a 9mm press, a 40 cal press, a 45 press, a 223 press. I've got where I can make my own bullets. I've got another single. I've got another single here. I've got a powder dispenser here. As you can see, here's some of the ammo that I've accumulated buying it. I've got my brass on the top shelf. Everything's been cleaned. And behind me, I've got all my bullets. And up here, I have all my powder. And the reason why I went this direction is I got tired of wanting to go and buy ammo and it's not available. So what I'm able to do right now is all the calibers, presses, I can reload everything I shoot. And also have a single press for some of my other ones, like 7.62x39s, 7.62x54s, let's see, I think a 357, and some of the ones that I don't shoot a lot of, I can do on the single press. I don't buy any ammo to resell. I'm not out there gouging. I reload for my own pleasure. And I also can't say that I'm saving a lot of money by reloading myself with the high cost of what it costs for supplies and especially your powders. I want to take a moment with my old press that I had. Is it was mounted on the side of the bench, and what happens is the mounting bolts on a Lee's press are so close to the edge it splits this out. And also you see a lot of people where they're going and they pull it down and you'll notice that the table's moving. There's a gentleman out there, his name is Richard Beck, and I got lucky. I was on the YouTube one night and he was showing some of his mounts that he's got. And all my presses for the most part are a Lee Master loader. So he's already drilled the holes for the press. He's already drilled the holes for my red box here for catching my rounds. And on the front of it, he's also added, on the back of it, he's got the four mounting screws. One thing that I added to this is I made a template of what he sent me. And I'm able to take this and drill it into the front of my benches. And this is solid, it's painted, high quality. And I don't know about you, but most of the time when I drill holes in certain places, I go to mount the press on it and the holes don't line up. I can honestly tell you, I think I bought 12 or 13 of these from Richard. I was able to take my press, mount it to my bench, put the press on it, drop the screws, tighten it up. And also these holes for the brackets here, every single hole is exactly perfect. These are a good quality mount. I recommend them to everyone. And his email address is Richard_D_Beck@hotmail.com. Again, his name is Richard Beck. If you go out there and put type in reloading mounts, he's got a few out there. And like I said, depending on how many quantity that you're asking for, he can pretty well build you anything you want. He can build you some custom ones. He built a custom one here for me. And if you don't want the holes drilled or you want them drilled differently, you just need to let him know what you want. And tell you what, Richard's good quality. When he tells you he's going to get something done, he gets it done, and he's really quick at it. So I can't say enough good things about these presses. One thing I can tell you is before I mounted my presses, some people wanted to see how good these are. Is I weigh about 240, and I can stand on this, and my bench don't even flinch. It don't even move. So again, he also has another version that actually mounts underneath the wooden bench to also give it structure and support as well. So I can't say enough good things about these mounts, but I'll tell you what, if you invest in some of them, the days of having it all split out from the front, the days of having where you pull your handle down and your press is moving up and down and all that, you don't have it with this. So again, if I've messed this up or if I have something wrong with this email and you can't get a hold of Richard Beck, go ahead and respond on my YouTube video and I will make sure that he gets a copy of your address or at least your email and we can get some of these set up for you to build as well if you want them. But well worth the money. Until next time, I'll start talking and showing different things about my presses and going through the mods and modifications and some different technology to bring to everyone. And hey, good shooting. Thanks.